How many people coming here to learn something or to pass the time? How many people coming here to learn something or to pass the time? யாராரு ஏதாவது கொஞ்சம் கத்திக்கணும் என்று நினைக்க சாரி எனி ஒன் ஹூ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு லேர்ன் சம்திங் ப்ளீஸ் ரைஸ் யுவர் ஹேண்ட்ஸ் எனிபடி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு பாஸ் யுவர் டைம் நைஸ்லி ஃபார் தட் யூ ஆர் கமிங் கேன் ரைஸ் யூ அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் லேர்னிங் மீன்ஸ் வாட் Here is thought that we should implement in our life, isn't it? Now we are doing the purpose of ISKCON, isn't it? The purpose of ISKCON, the founder Acharya, Srila Prabhupada, this realizations. He put 7 purposes. The very first purpose is systematically we have to learn and implement in our life, isn't it? So what is the thing, any action we do, that action, how we can say that one, the action is all fruitful, all success? How we can say that one, our action is all fruitful, all successful, all perfect? How we can say
the purpose is served to
please Krishna, isn't it? Suppose every Sunday evening we have nice program, somebody is inviting you, what you do, you go to that program or you come to this one? This is only formally you are telling, not really, isn't it? How many times you skip the Sunday program and went somewhere else? Do you have like that in any of your experience? You remember? You skipping this program and going somewhere else for some other program? நான் கேட்கறது உங்களே, ஐ ஆம் asking about you. He's blinking. Ninga Prabhu, you yourself, how many times you skip the Sunday program and you've been to some other program? Few times. Yourself? கத்தியம் வந்துட்டு இருக்கணும். ஏதோ ஒரு சண்டே வரல, ஊருக்கு போனீங்களே என்னமோ, உங்கள் ஃப்ரெண்டு வந்துருக்கல இன்னைக்கு, நீங்கள் வரல, கரெக்டாக இல்லையா? எனக்கு தெரிஞ்சு இவர் கரெக்டாக வந்துட்டு இருக்கார். இட்ஸ் வெரி பர்ஃபெக்ட். ஸோ திஸ் வே வி ஹேவ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட், கம்மிங் ஹியர் இஸ் ப்ளீஸிங் கிருஷ்ணா, அட்டெண்டிங் சம்திங் ஹியர்ஸ் இஸ் ப்ளீஸிங் கிருஷ்ணா. விச் இஸ் பெட்டர்,
கம்மிங் ஹியர்?
Mataji should tell. If it is compulsory to attend something else, what you do? Somebody invited you, what you do? Still you are not understanding my question. You are invited for someday, but you have here one Sunday where you can learn your life. That is also important. You have to attend that also. What you do? Anyone?
B.
Sorry? So that is the excuse. Yeah? Because I can listen this one to record, this one uploaded one, so I can skip this program. Any intelligent here? Sunday you are invited. Sunday this time is fixed. Huh? What you do? He is intelligent person. This time you cannot go. You should go before or later. And that shows how much you are eager, how much you are serious, how much you surrender to Krishna, how much you are interested in yourself to learn the things. Isn't it? The same time you are telling, excusing. So in this way Krishna is pleased, skipping this program, attending something else. Is Krishna pleased? In our action, if Krishna is not pleased, what we are going to have? What you are going to have? Problems, sufferings, unsolved problems. This is the way we get. Isn't it? Today morning was the time for my brother-in-law's milk pouring. My brother-in-law expired on Friday. So today they are taking the milk and cleaning the bone skins and all. But really I did not go. I informed them I cannot come. I have very good program for Sunday. I skip that program and come here. Which is better? How many of you did like this one in your life? How many relatives you have those who are not devotees and you have attachment for them? What is the resultant of that one? What is the resultant of that one?
We have to go.
You are going to become non-devotee. This is the association. Isn't it? You want to give association and they want to accept your association. Which is better? The same thing even in ISKCON we have the purpose. If the purpose is not served, we are wasting our life. You can see, so many devotees are not happy. Am I correct or not? Among you also, you can ask yourself, keeping the hand on your heart, and you can ask whether I am completely happy. Hardly few can say, otherwise not. Because we are not accepting what Krishna is telling. Krishna is telling, Arjuna is telling, Karishe Vachanantava, but we are not following. So we are bound to get
problems,
sufferings. You understand? Please understand that this is the last purpose of what Prabhupada taught us. At least now we don't understand. We cannot expect the mercy of Krishna. We have to face the consequences. Isn't it? But I have very nice chance for even that day, the Friday itself, in the presence of the dead body, I took some class also. I made those who are visitors, I made them to chant Hare Krishna also. But today I was absent. Am I going to get any reaction for that one? You understand? Please understand, anything that we are doing, that should please Krishna. Still after some years also we are doing like this. Krishna never showers
mercy.
We have to remain where we were. we don't advance. Accept this one seriously. This very, very rare opportunity to get into ISKCON. In ISKCON, what all the realizations? My, particularly my realizations?
Don't find fault with anyone.
Don't find faults with anyone. Some people, they don't like, among devotees also, that devotee is not good, this was not good, better for me not to associate with them, that time. And another one is?
Don't create enmity.
Don't create, they create enmity, I don't want to speak to them, I don't want to look at them. They may be devotees, but they are not perfect. If I go there, I will also become like that one. That one?
Don't take part in any disputes.
Not to take part with anyone in a dispute. If anybody has some dispute, why the dispute arises?
Self-motivation.
You wait, yesterday you had the class, huh? Yesterday class, how many people you heard? They can easily understand. Srimad Bhagavatam classes are very, very, I don't know, that's really very, very good, clear understanding. Why the disputes coming? Because of?
Self-motivation.
Self-motivation. I have something. There is dispute. If anyone has any dispute, both are wrong. A Vaishnava never? A Vaishnava never has?
Enemies. Enemies.
A Vaishnava never has? Dispute. So those who are in dispute, they are not Vaishnavas. They are selfish. A pure Vaishnava cannot take part with anyone selfish. As though they are disguised as Vaishnava devotees. You understand the point? So he has to preach them both. Both are wrong. Isn't it? The fourth one, many people they say that all the three it's okay, Prabhu. But the fourth one is very, very difficult. I meet many people and they tell, no? What is the fourth one?
Don't be the cause of this.
Don't become the cause for the distress of anyone else. Clearly you have to speak. Giving lecture means we have to speak slowly, clearly. The audience should understand that one. We do not want to show our vocabulary, intelligence, this, that and all. We have to aim that how best I can convey to the audience. We have to speak very clearly. Then only we can actually pass on something to others, otherwise not. Isn't it? The fourth one is very, very important. If by chance one is displeased because of the purification, then we ask someone, try to get up early in the morning, Brahma Muhurta time, try to chant. But that fellow thinks, oh, why he is telling me like this one? I don't like him. I don't want to do. He feels he is hurting me, hurting my sentiments. In that case, what to do? What to compromise? Do you want to compromise? A preacher should be
bold.
Bold means tell as it is. Don't hide anything. Bold. The this is the thing, it is up to you whether you get up early in the morning or not. It's up to you. This is my duty, I have to tell you. Isn't it? So this way we have come to the last purpose. The nature, you see, the nature helps everybody, just born baby. Normally, after a year, is there any changes in the baby? Is there any change in the baby?
Grows. It grows.
Grows, no? This is due to nature. But if a person is coming to the class, he is in this class for 1 year, if he doesn't get anything, what we can think? Which is better? Nature is better or ourself is better? This is what we have to understand, that nowhere you will get all these points. This is not only the realized knowledge. A baby, there is a growth. Within 1 year, the baby may walk also. Isn't it? May speak also. But we are as it is, as we were. What is the use? Is Krishna pleased? Please understand. Each year we have to check ourselves. Every festival, Janmashtami, Narasimha Jayanti, and then Gaur Purnima. How was I last Janmashtami? Today is Janmashtami, this year new Janmashtami. What is the changes? You understand? This we have to check up ourselves. How much I advanced? Otherwise we become?
Nothing.
Become?
Pretenders.
Better answer.
Prakriti devotee.
Prakruta is okay, even better than that one. Prakruta is in the view of others. But he thinks it's okay. You told which word you told?
Pretender.
Pretenders also for others. Others think, oh, he's a pretender man. But you are not, cheating ourselves. That is called hypocrisy. He is hypocritic. The person is hypocritic. That noun form is hypocrisy. Hypocritic means he cannot enjoy himself materially. He cannot release himself spiritually. You enjoy? You understand? You are in middle. You do not know what to do, what not to do. For the whole world know that when I am the deity, but we cannot release anything in spiritual, this one. At the same time, in material, we cannot enjoy anything. This is called hypocrisy. You understand? No one should become hypocritic in ISKCON. If you become like that one, he is going to suffer. They are going to become pretenders. They are going to cheat themselves. Try to understand. Anything that we do, it should please Krishna. You can change your programs accordingly. Otherwise lost. In my attendance, even in school, even in college, 100% my attendance. I told once, that when I was doing my B.Tech, normally one day, I'm always leader, I'm leader, so all my group people, they told that we are in Giddi AC College and in Adyar Center, there is newly one hotel is opened at that time. They told that we all going to the hotel, Prabhuji. They did not know Prabhu at that time. They were telling, we are going there, we want to have lunch there. So I want to please them, I also went there. We had lunch welcoming the Panwala was sitting there. So everybody told that we want to take pan. So okay. In that also first what they do, they don't take anyone. They just give me first. I beat it. I do not know where I am, what I am doing, what I am. I do not know whether I am walking or I am flying. So everybody got me, they hold me. I told her, I am sorry, I do not know what I am doing, what is this one? I spit that one out. You understand? Then they took me up to the bus stand, and bus stand, we got up, and then we got down in our college. We went to the classroom. They hold me. I did not walk on my own. Then my master came. What happened to him? So he took that pawn and then something happened. That day, my master declared that day off day is holiday. No other time we never had any holidays. You understand? The master declared, holiday. We have to show our interest, how best I can learn. It is not that one, how best I become famous. Last class, many people got confused, isn't it? Including Bhakta Rupa, Leela Mataji, Sundara Murari, I think so, Anya, Anuradha Mataji also, all got doubt, isn't it? Then I send mail, long mails to explain them. We should always think that how best I can help others. Which is better? I want to help others having empty pocket. I want to help others with filled pocket. Which is better?
Filled pocket.
With filled pocket. Filled pocket means?
Merci.
You should have, you should possess. Mercy of
Krishna.
With the empty pocket, you don't have mercy, and you are going and you are associating. How best you are going to give them mercy? Isn't it? So, a good preacher never think how much I have in my pocket. But he wants to try to help others. You understand? A good preacher wants to preach others, then what the pre-qualification for him? What the pre-qualification for him? He should be perfect. He should have possessed that quality. Isn't it? Am I correct? That time, any pupil can say anything about me, no problem. But I want to help others. You understand? Envy people, they always criticize, they always mock you. Isn't it? Who are envious persons? Can you not tell? How a person become envious? Sometimes even husbands, they become envious of the wives. What could be the reason? Common reason? What the husband doesn't have, if they find that one with the wives, then they will become envious. So envious means two persons doing the same profession. If one possesses the same thing extraordinarily, the other person will become envious of that one. person. Please understand that. So this person who is envious of that person is not at all Krishna conscious, is not at all a devotee. Please understand. We cannot have envy with anyone. You understand? We cannot have envy with anyone. The same thing, Krishna being served. Huh? One side, Radharani and groups. Another side? Huh? Huh? Chandravali and her group. So in our temple is Kanchanai, we have Krishna in middle. One side, Krishna's right side, Radharani, and left side, Chandravali. Huh? The small deities. They are competitors, but they were not envious of each other. You understand? This spiritual life. Radharani does always very, very nicely. Chandravali thinks, oh, Radharani, you are doing so nicely. I want to do even better than that one. I want to please Krishna more. But she never becomes a hindrance in the way of Radharani. But in our material world, we become hindrance. Isn't it? So we are not spiritual. Understand? If we have some enmity with them, I do not want to mingle with them. So they never have the mercy of Krishna. That's why what in Chaitanya Charitamrita we learned. You can embrace, but you cannot embrace, who are the teaster? You can embrace, but you cannot embrace. You can embrace a tiger, but you cannot embrace a envious person. Normally, envious people are impersonalists because they do not want to know, understand Krishna. So they become impersonalists. They become Mayavadis at last. You can embrace that tiger. But it is very dangerous to mingle with such people. These classes and all really for our own purification. But if you take this casual, then Krishna will never turn to us. If you become serious, Krishna will also become serious to help us. If you take casual, then Krishna will also neglect you. He will never take care. So these purposes are very, very important. Prabhupada, he sacrificed his life. Why can't I sacrifice? The question we have to say. Don't look at others. That's very, very difficult. That's what Prabhupada told. Anyone reads my book, they collect some information, and if they visit any center, they should not find any
discrepancies.
Hindrance. Difference. Then ask this, what I have given in my books, they have to witness in all the centers. But that is not so. We are not up to that mark. So why don't we try to come to that point? This is my effort actually. That's why by the mercy of Krishna my friend has come, Devanand Prabhu. He took in one class Srinath Prabhu's place. in 1 hour you finish off everything. Then only Krishna inspired me, you have to take all these things. So in that way I have come today, the last one. Next one is part 4, today is part 3. Next class will be the summary of all the 7 purposes. We have to revise that one again. Please understand, don't neglect this class. If anyone skip this class, Krishna will skip your life. Don't give importance to any other thing than this one. You were thinking that you are expert singer and expert mridanga player. Am I correct? Before today's class, you were thinking that you are very good singer and expert mridanga player. You never thought like that. You think that anyone else is better singer and better player, mridanga player? Did you ever thought like that one? You never thought that one. You never puffed up yourself. No, very good. And after this today's class, how did you feel? Better service. Before that one, what? Ignorant, okay, then what happened? You are getting purpose of this life, material world is? You are getting purified, that you have to say. You are doing something wrong, that is the contaminated stage. You are getting on right, that is called the purification. If you are pure, then only you can make others pure. Always not. Isn't it? You understand? We should not feel shy, yeah? I am getting something. What other people will think of me? I am so great. I am earning 3 lakh rupees a month. 3 lakh rupees a month. My brother-in-law, he expert, he had so many buildings, he was the owner of buildings. He had factories, he had the shops, well going, assured all. This person possessed so many things, what all the things he is taking, carrying with, along with him. With that property, their brothers, their children, they all fighting. The beauty is that one, huh? It's not the end. Because he had that much wealth, his brothers, his children, brothers' children, they had very fighting, very nice fighting. What is the use? You understand the point? Our life is ISKCON, people should not behave like that one. He paid for my school fees also once upon a time. He helped us also many times. Such a person today is lying. You understand? The purpose of coming to this program is to purify ourselves. You are skipping the program means, what is it? No one can give the answer. You are coming for this program is only for your purification. If you are skipping this program, then
entanglement. Entanglement.
I don't want to get purified. But I want to purify others. Isn't it? So this and all, the very last purpose is not that much actually. It's very, very simple thing. That's why I thought it's better for all of you to understand the purpose of our action. Isn't it? Otherwise, we are going to lose our human form. Manushya,
Janamapaya.
Janamapaya. ராதா கிருஷ்ண நாதாஜியா. ராதா கிருஷ்ண பிராண மோரா தென்
யுகல
கிஷோரா. வாட் டஸ் இட் மீன்? ராதா கிருஷ்ண பிராண மோரா.
மை லைஃப், யா
மை லைஃப் இஸ் ராதா கிருஷ்ண யுகல கிஷோரா. கிஷோரா மீன்ஸ் always young, is eternally young fellow. Yugala means yugala, yugala geet. Even film songs under yugala geet, that is Hindi word. Tamil they don't use. Tamil people, they don't. Yugala, yugala means to eat, to yugala. In Telugu we know. You don't know yugala geetam? You never had? You never had to film songs and all in your life? Good, very nice, huh? Anyway, you also will get spoiled like me. You gala, gala means voice, huh? Gala, gala. You means two. Kishori, who is the other one? Yugala Kishora, who is the other one?
Nada.
Kishori. Radha name is Kishori. Krishna is Kishora. Shyam, Shyama. Same names both. Huh? Isn't it? Madhavi, Madhava. Huh? Isn't it? So this way, Yugala Kishora. Even if you see Krishna, Krishna is not single person, he is two persons. Huh? Krishna plus, who is Radharani? Is internal pleasure potency. They are my life. If you want to be happy, you want to be ever young, without any disease, you should accept your life as only for Kishore and Kishori, not anything else. This is, if you take this one casually and time passing, you are losing, you are passing your life. Isn't it? So better understand the importance of not skipping these programs. Now we'll continue the seventh purpose. Please take down. Take down the term, statement, with a view towards achieving, aforementioned, purposes. With a view towards achieving aforementioned purposes, to publish and distribute with a view towards achieving aforementioned purposes, to publish and distribute periodicals, magazines. books and other writings, to publish and distribute periodicals, magazines, books and other writings. What is the main statement here? What is very important? Achieving aforementioned purposes, very correct. How it is done? How it is done? Distribute?
Periodicals,
magazines, books and other writings. If the purpose is there and that is not served, that is not achieved, what is the use of that one? Now we were talking about the nature. Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram. Satyam. We learnt what is truth. What is the truth? As soon as?
Death.
Death. That is truth. Isn't it? But how many of us taking care before we face our death? How many of you thinking that, how can I prevent my death? A hunter is there. Hunter saw one rabbit. Hunter is there. Hunter saw one rabbit. How intelligent the rabbit is. Can anyone tell this one? I must have explained this one also long time back, sometime. One hunter is there and he found one rabbit. The rabbit is so intelligent. He doesn't want to die. Hunter means he's going to kill. That is sure. But the rabbit, he doesn't want to be killed. What? How? He is presenting his intelligence. Can anyone of you? So I'm a deaf person. By? Running away. Any other solution? Wait. Any other answer? If the rabbit comes towards hunter and taking the shelter at the lotus feet of the hunter, the hunter, his heart got melted. He never wanted to kill. He wanted to protect. Isn't it? Not only killing, but he wants to protect. The death personification is the Sarva Harat Chaham. Krishna is telling. Sarva Harat Chaham Chaham. I am going to devour all of you, everything. The death personification, Krishna in the form of death personification. And is going to kill you surely. What you have to do?
Surrender.
You have less intelligence than rabbit. Rabbits are better than us. We are less intelligent than the rabbit. But we are not surrendering. Isn't it? How nicely Krishna is concluding his Bhagavad Gita. Sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam saranam vraja. Aham tvam sarva papebhya moksha isyami vasucharya. But we do not want to give up all other religious principles. We want to hold on. How we can expect Krishna? கிருஷ்ணா கேன் டூ
இம்பாசிபிள் பாசிபிள்
ஃபார் அஸ் இட் இஸ் இம்பாசிபிள் இஃப் யூ சரண்டர் டு கிருஷ்ணா கிருஷ்ணா கேன் மேக் இட்ஸ் இம்பாசிபிள் பாசிபிள் பட் வீ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் டு கிவ் சான்ஸ் டு கிருஷ்ணா வீ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் ஃபெய்த் இன் கிருஷ்ணா வீ திங்க் தட் வீ ஆர் பெட்டர் தென் கிருஷ்ணா வீ திங்க் தேர் இஸ் நோ கிருஷ்ணா தீஸ் ஆர் தி எக்ஸ்கியூசஸ் That's why we are failing in our lives. Huh? We cannot take care of ourselves. How much intelligent we are. Isn't it? BJP wanted to conquer the assembly of Karnataka state, but it was not possible. Huh? Isn't it? Kumaraswamy, he was not at all, he tried but he could not. But at last he is the winner. Isn't it? In this material world, we cannot predict anything. One thing we can predict. What is that one? Huh? One we can predict. Everything we cannot predict. We think something and happening something else. But one thing is certain. One thing we can predict. What is that one?
Uncertainty.
Huh?
Uncertainty.
Yes. Uncertainty is certain. Hmm? What was my question?
We can predict.
Certainly. What is that one? That is even a fool can understand. What we can predict. Ye yathamam prapachyante tam tathaiva bhajamyaham. What we can predict. If I surrender to Krishna, Krishna can only protect me. That is certain. If I surrender to Krishna, then I am protected by Krishna. That is certain. Huh? Father told me a very nice example. No? Draupadi, she showed. Draupadi is not at all an ordinary woman. She was burned from fire. Even such a soul. Had to face so many problems. Isn't it? But still, she proved that one, Krishna cannot give up his extended hand. How many of us have that faith? Please understand. Develop your faith. Saranagati. In the Saranagati, we need this one, no? Firmly, somehow or other, Krishna will help me. I should not go to somewhere else. Definitely Krishna will help me. Even if there is death, what is the loss? What is the loss? What is the gain?
Spiritual body.
We are going back home, back to Godhead. That is also protected by Krishna. That way also we are protected. Even in a great loss also, there is no loss. For materialists, the greatest loss is death. But for spiritual persons, the greatest loss of material things is the negligible. That is the greatest profit. For materialists, what is the greatest loss? The greatest gain for spiritual person. This much difference between non-devotee and devotee. Isn't it? What are the purposes? The above six purposes Prabhupada mentioned. that and all, we have to read the statement. You have to achieve. If you don't achieve, who is in loss? We only. So it is determined to achieve all the purposes. What is the use? You are studying 1 year. At the final examination, annual examination, you failed. You are wasting 1 year. In one lifetime, at the time of giving up the body, you are unable to think of Krishna. You wasted one life. Thinking of Krishna at the time of death is better. Accumulating wealth, gold, silver, this, that, and all, which is better? Please understand. This one we should understand in Krishna consciousness. Everything is possessed by Krishna. All the gold, silver, these diamonds, this, that, and all owned by Krishna. Krishna is the owner. If we want that one, we are grabbing from Krishna. So we are becoming
thieves.
We are becoming enemies of Krishna. How Krishna can protect us? Isn't it? So please understand, all the purposes is not just like the writings on the water. You have that one, like that some statement in Tamil?
Tannir kolam.
Tannir?
Tannir kolam podaing. Tannir kolam.
Kolam. Achha. So anything you write in the water, that will not last. Isn't it? So like that one, we cannot write anything in water. Just for writing's sake. That we have to implement in our life. You understand? This and all, actually, I'm thinking myself how I'm speaking without preparing and all. This is what I learned from my Guru Maharaj, Nadana Swamaraj. He explains like that. I learned from him like that one. He was not spiritual master. He was the assistant of Kirtanananda Swami. First guru is my guru is Kirtanananda Swami. That day we had lot of time with Radhana Swami Raj. He taught us. I normally go early in the morning, and my workplace is only closer to our temple Chaupati. With one bus I can go and come back. Afternoon I come. Evening I'll come. It taught me so many things. Taught us like that one. That time we were a very small group also. Today I'm wondering myself that it's not possible for me to speak and explain. You're all understanding what I'm telling? This is all due to only my Guru's mercy. When he's speaking, I look at him, he also often look at me. Eye contact is there. That's why even today I'm so proud of my Guru Maharaj. Now you can see that I left Bombay even more than 20 years, 25 years. But still, what all I learned from my Guru Maharaj, today I can repeat that one. Isn't it? Please don't waste our time. This is the golden opportunity. We have to achieve all the purposes. We cannot achieve anything else on our own. It is only we can achieve by the mercy of Krishna. Don't try to achieve anything. Try to achieve. Don't try to achieve to get anything. Try to achieve to get mercy of Krishna. This sloka now you can see ஸ்ரேயான் ஸ்வதர்மோ விகுணஹ பரதர்மோ ஸ்வனிஷ்டிதாஹ. ஸ்வதர்மே நிதனம் ஸ்ரேயா பரதர்மோ பயாவகா. ப்ளீஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் திஸ் சார், யூ ஹாவ் டு டூ யுவர் டியூட்டி ஈவன் இஃப் இட் இஸ் ஃபால்ட்டி. யூ மே டூ சம் ஒன் எல்ஸ் டியூட்டி சோ நைஸ்லி, பட் ஸ்டில் டோன்ட் டூ தட் ஒன் யூ டூ ஈவன் இன் யுவர் ஓன் பிரிஸ்கிரைப் டியூட்டி. யூ வில் கெட் டிஸ்ட்ரெக்ஸ்ட், யூ ஆர் கோயிங் டு லூஸ் எவ்ரி திங். தென் ஆல்சோ யூ டூ தட் ஒன் பிகாஸ் யூ கேனாட் அச்சீவ் எனி திங். ஈவன் யூ ஆர் டூயிங் சோ நைஸ்லி சம்திங் எல்ஸ், தேர் யூ மே கெட் சோ மெனி திங்ஸ், பட் ஸ்டில் யூ ஆர் த லூசர். Sometimes Krishna makarive call Arjuna. What is that one? That word? Now in this context you can easily say, O Dhananjaya, conqueror of the wealth. But he's criticizing. You are a conqueror of all the wealth throughout the world, but you don't have even this much. Silly things. Huh? It's not mockery. It's not chastising. Huh? So, even if you don't bother to conquer anything else, but if you bother to conquer the mercy of Krishna, you are all successful. Is not? On your own, you cannot achieve anything. Please understand. Krishna is telling it is impossible for you to win Duryodhana. Because he has Bhishma, Drona, so great. They are unconquerable. That's why you don't run away from this war field. Huh? Somebody told her, the rabbit, try to run away. No, Krishna never advised. You fight, but thinking of me, depending upon my mercy, you are all successful. That's impossible. To win Bhishma, is it possible? Huh? He gave the 5 arrows to Duryodhana himself. But how Krishna can make the possible, impossible, impossible, possible? Isn't it? Just depend upon the mercy of Krishna, you are successful. Don't prove yourself so. You are Nobel Prize winner, I am this, I am that. Nothing is going to. Nahi nahi. Rakshati dumkum karani. Even, the Shankaracharya is telling like this one. You only spread impersonalism, mayavadam. But he himself telling, these fools, you just worship Govinda, Govinda, Govinda. What all you learnt, your trickery words, jugglery words, that is not going to help you at the time you are going to give up your body. Nahi nahi rakshati. Understand how much we are fortunate to come to this call. No? Did you really realize that point? நீங்க புரிஞ்சிட்டீங்களா இந்த வார்த்தை எவ்வளவு இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் டிஸ்கவுண்ட் வருது? பிஃபோர் கமிங் டிஸ்கவுண்ட் ஆல்சோ ஐ ட்ரைட் மெனி மெனி பிளேசஸ் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப்டர் மீ டூயிங் பிடெக் I am not at all happy in any work. I worked for Century Mill, I worked for Sri Ram Mill, I worked for Arbuda Mill, so much, but I am not at all happy. Please understand. I am not at all happy. So I used to get all the books and read also. Vivekananda books also I read many times. I was not at all happy. That time Chaupati Temple was not there, but opposite that one, what is that one? The hall? Bharatiya Vidya Bhavan. There is one lecturer is coming and taking Bhagavad Gita class. ஐ வாஸ் இன் அந்தேரி, அந்தேரி ஜேபி நகர். ஃப்ரம் ஜேபி நகர் ஐ ஹேவ் டு கம் டு திஸ் ஒன் பை பாஸ், தென் ட்ரைன், தென் டு வாக். ஐ கம் ஐ அட்டண்டட், பட் தேர் ஆல்சோ ஐ காட் மை நோஸ் கட். ஐ புட் சம் க்வெஸ்சன் அண்ட் ஹி ரேட் மை நேம் யூ டின் பிரெண்ட் அண்ட் ஹி ரேட் இட் இஸ் மென்டலி அண்ட் இட் ஆல் தட் பன் தேர் இஸ் நோ நெசசிட்டி ஃபார் மீ டு ஆன்சர் சச் டைப் ஆஃப் க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ். ஐ காட் வெரி மச் இன்சல்டட். ஐ வாண்டட் டு கம் அவுட் பட் இன் தி மிடில் ஐ வாஸ் சிட்டிங் இன் த பால்கானி தி மிடில் ஸோ மெனி பீப்புள் இஃப் ஐ கெட் அப் அண்ட் கோ அவுட் இஸ் டசன்ட் லுக் நைஸ் ரீசன்ட் ஸோ ஐ வெயிட்டட் டில் த கிளாஸ் எண்ட். I was tolerating. I came down. Then outside, there is the ISKCON people, they held with this book table. There I picked up Bhagavad Gita as this. You see how Krishna is helping. After reading that Bhagavad Gita as this, today I can tell something to you. We have to learn as it is. Prabhupada gave us warnings also. Before you buy, learn the qualities of gold. Don't believe anyone. Follow sadhu sastra guru vakya chitate kariyaika. These two formulae are very, very important. So here, after achieving the purposes, we have to spread that one to the public. Whatever be the thing we got, if we keep that one within us, we also become selfish thieves. This knowledge we got from others. On my own, I didn't get. Is it? By the mercy of others, I got it. So it is the gratitude I had to show now that is spread this way to others. Otherwise, it's impossible to repay our gurus. Many people, they ask, Prabhupada, you changed our life. You showed us the clear-cut picture. You did so many things. It is impossible for us to repay you. How can we repay you? For his mind, he did not understand, how can I repay to my Guru Maharaj? Then Prabhupada tells, don't think of all those things. I don't expect anything you to repay me. Don't try to repay me. But if you want to repay me, you have to spread what all you learn from me to others. That is, you are showing my gratitude. We cannot keep it ourselves, selfish. A realized person never sits in a corner in a AC room with all facilities. He will go out, call everyone, and he reveal what he realized. He is the pure devotee. He is a Vaishnava. He cannot keep himself. So here it is mentioned that after achieving all the purposes, we have to extend our hand to the public. Through periodicals that comes in period wise, daily, weekly, bi-weekly, fortnight, monthly, quarterly, bi-monthly, half-yearly, annually. These are all the periodicals. Through that we can remind all the people. Periodically that comes means we are ever now and then we are knocking the door, isn't it? So they wake up. Then magazines. In magazines you can find illustrated things with pictures, sketches and all. very nicely anyone can understand. And then?
Books.
Books. The books are not ordinary books. Our ISKCON books are not ordinary books. They are the books of Krishna. Krishna himself dictated. Prabhupada has written them. This is Krishna. There is no difference between the books of Prabhupada and Krishna. You understand? Don't neglect. It is not possible for everyone to preach also. But if you distribute one book, you are getting so much credit. Sometimes even the preachers, they cannot get that credit. Isn't it? But if you are able to distribute and make them to read that book, that person's life is successful. Isn't it? I also got this Bhagavad Gita as it is. Because of that only today I am here. Before that one I read so many Bhagavad Gitas. You understand? But I never understood anything. Please understand. But this is as it is. As it is means it has the mercy of Krishna. It is not the person's mercy, it is Krishna's mercy coming through him. The gurus, how many types of gurus are there?
Three.
What are they?
Chaitya Guru. Chaitya Guru. Parama. Chaitya Guru.
Okay.
Shiksha Guru, Diksha Guru.
Aksha. Suppose a light is there. Krishna just comes to the light rays. Light. Krishna is a light. The rays of the mercy of Krishna. How many gurus? In that way, how many gurus you can say? That is, I told that one, this is not the mercy of the guru, in fact, that is the mercy of Krishna. So how many gurus can be there? Transparent?
Opaque?
Translucent. Isn't it? Now you got the point? Who is better? Why? How can you say that when it means better way is
giving as it is.
He is selfless. That is very, very important. He is selfless. He doesn't want to have anything of Krishna. He wants to keep distribute. That's transparent. Opaque means? He doesn't want to give anything. Completely he has to use for himself. 100% selfish. The transparent 100% selfless. The opaque is? 1 to 99. ranging from 1 to 99. Any in between. Isn't it? So this way we have to understand how best we can please Guru and Krishna. Brahmana, Brahmite Kona, Bhagyavan Jiva, Guru Krishna Prasade Bhaya, Bhakti Lata Picha. Isn't it? Am I correct? So Madhuri, if you get that Bhakti Lata Bija, we should not misuse. Then everything is fixed. Isn't it? It means what through the books, writings also. Writings you are getting by notes also. Sometimes that much only I could able to do. Is that useful? Is it for you also is useful? So this way you should also try to pray Krishna. Krishna make me pure. and use me as your powerful instrument to make this your conscience. Before coming to ISKCON, I used to pray, Krishna, I do not want to do any mistake. I do not want to do any sinful action. I want to be the exemplary for the rest of the world. I don't know, this is my knowledge before coming to ISKCON also. I want to be the best exemplary for the rest of the world. Any step I keep, you please help me. Any word I use to speak, you help me. Any thought I think, you please help me to think. Whether you believe it or not, I used to pray Krishna like that from before coming to ISKCON itself. So better, you should also have some determination. I want to become pure. I want to help others. I want to make others pure. Then definitely Krishna helps us. In this regard, whatever I told you before, you pray like this one, it will be done.
Don't try to achieve anything. Try to achieve Krishna's mercy.
Mercy of Krishna. So for that one, one more very important point I told. One certain thing you can have. The certain thing is? Surrender to Krishna, Krishna will protect you. Surrender utterly to Krishna. Krishna will protect you utterly. Then only we can help others. Otherwise that is not possible. Okay? Hare Krishna, thank you very much. If anybody has any doubt or clarification required, is it 2 hours, 1 hour? Anyone has any doubt, please? Don't think that when to pass your time you are coming here. You have to learn something and implement in your life and purify yourself. Then only we can purify others. Otherwise that is impossible. Yes? No one? Yes? Yes. Yes. Actually, I could not get that question. What is the question? Yes, you understand. They are very nicely surrendered, yeah.
But our lives, is even the movement?
It's not even 1% of what they surrendered.
How we overcome the...
Your shortcoming. That's why I'm telling, actually we are in ISKCON, we are giving training. You can do anything, yat karo se, yat asna se, jo se, tada se. Why I'm telling, what is happening, I'm trying to make you understand. Any event happens, that is called, I took some classes, case studies. You understand? In middle, I took some case studies and all. Case study means what you experienced outside of yourself, but you don't understand how we can make the situation Krishna conscious, how to surrender to Krishna. You understand? That cases I took some, isn't it? Like that one, if you understand any action you are doing, that action is only to please Krishna. You also ask me on Sivaratri what you can do, isn't it? Even if you please Shiva, Krishna is also happy. even if you neglect to please the ant, insignificant ant, Krishna is not pleased. Huh? Isn't it? So this is the thing you have to learn from the realized souls. What are the to do, what are not to do. If we are doing, worshipping Lord Shiva, and after one preacher came and told why you are doing this foolish action, why you are trying to please Shiva, and you stop it, Krishna will never become happy. Even in Bhagavad Gita we can see, if someone is addicted to worship some demigod, you cannot stop them to worship that one. Everything is going to ultimate to Krishna. But we have to make them understand. On their own they should understand what is better than this. After finishing 5th standard, he has to go to 6th standard, that is obvious. That understanding they should take. In our ISKCON also there were so many people, they addicted to worship Ganesha, Durga. But all now, they understood that it's not necessary. So they come to Krishna consciousness. But we cannot force them, you stop worshipping Ganesha. No. If you cannot go to Krishna directly, you can go step by step. You can worship Lord Ganesha also, no problem. But don't have any self motivation. That's the thing we can tell. We cannot stop them. So very easily anything, you people, because you are not going out, you are not dealing with anyone else, you are at home, you are so fortunate. You understand, you are not earning any money. So your action is only to please Krishna. Don't think that when I am preparing this one for my son's birthday, that's why I'm preparing cake. We have that mentality. But what the mentality should have? Krishna, today is my son's birthday. So today, I want him to feed your abundance with some special item. But what normally we think? Today is my son's birthday, let me have one. Krishna, please accept this one. Don't think that one. Krishna, at least today, you have to bless him. You have to give him your remnants, special remnants today, being the special day. I am preparing something special, extraordinary. I am offering you. Please. Ordinary days, that idli, sambar, chapati, that and all over. But I am especially for this one. Today my son should get more blessings from you. Special mercy of yours. I am making a special item. Then Krishna cannot hear your words. So it is very easy. You are going outside, you are earning some money. Your mentality is how best I can earn more money. You have some cheating propensities also. Sweet. So only the people, those who are trying to maintain themselves, they may have all those unwanted things. But people like you, you don't have anything. That's why we don't even insist that people, those who are not working, even the old priest, where are your mother-in-law, father-in-law? They were out of station? Native place. Isn't it? Father Mandal, we don't insist. We chant 64 rounds. Listen, if they just given the prasadam, remnants of Krishna, and chant Hare Krishna, how they are chanting, it's okay. If they touch, if they do something, no problem. Because they are not going to cheat anyone, they are not going to harm anyone, because their age is over. They are not earning money. So in that way, it is not at all possible for us not to become Krishna conscious. Particularly for old people, Prabhupada, he told that one, they have to come to the centers. The centers are all also for old age ashram. They should come there, they should serve something according to their ability to serve Krishna. They can cut some vegetables, they can make some garlands. they can do according to their strength, they can do. That facility is given. Previously, it is told that they have to go to some other, they have to leave the family, what is the problem? Vanaprastha. Now, Vanaprastha means they can go to the center and stay there. So, Prabhupada also facilitated us so many ways. So, those who are in Krishna consciousness, we need not bother that one. How can I surrender to Krishna? Whenever eating something, Krishna, this is your eminence. Those who are earning money to maintain their family, for them it is very, very difficult. But that's not difficult. It's easy for the easy people, difficult for the difficult people. You don't bother. You are going back home, back to Godhead. Yes, anything else?
There's a preacher, he has friends, relatives, and they are doing some mistakes. Okay, so can the preacher tell in a sugar-coated way so that there will not be misunderstanding and the relationship will be spoiled? So can he tell in a sugar-coated way, but that is not piercing the heart of the...
I never use the word of sugar-coated capsule.
But that will spoil the relationship.
I insisted that if you possess mercy of Krishna, you can convince them their mistake. You understand? We are not cheating. Sugar coated means that is cheating. If you explain that one, if they understand their mistake, if they can be able to rectify their mistake, if they confess that they were mistaken, then they can accept you. On your own, you cannot do all these things. If your sadhana is nice, if you get the mercy of Krishna, then only you can do this one. Otherwise, not possible. You don't blame them. How many times I'm telling them, they are not listening. But sometimes the people may be adamant. They do not want to accept. That is a different case. That's special category. Some people, they do not want to accept. They don't want to confess the mistake. No, I cannot do many mistakes. I'm always perfect. You don't teach me. Such people also there. But we have to pray only Krishna. Krishna, they are also your children. You please help. You understand? Don't think that when, how best I want to defeat him. Your mind is, how best I can defeat him, how best I can win him. That is not our process. That is not our job. We have to, how best I can insist him to chant Hare Krishna. How best I can make him understand the chanting of Hare Krishna is important. You understand? But many people think, I am correct, you are wrong. I want to prove that I am correct, you are wrong. In that one, we are not going to rectify them. You may be the winner. You may also tell that you are the winner, but he may not accept that one. We want him to accept Krishna consciousness. In which way? That is only by the mercy of Krishna. Dadhami buddhi yogam tum yena mam apayantate. You don't choose your intelligence. You don't prove that one you are better than him. But by the mercy of somebody else's mercy, you may become devotee. He may go beyond you also. You understand? You also have this experience. Those who were your teachers, Siksha Gurus in the beginning, you change the place, you come to some other place, there you are finding something else. You are advancing more than one day. You understand? So we do not want to try to show that one we are better than others. We have to explain. That is the thing I told. Preachers should be bold enough to make them understand their mistake. They can make their mistakes rectified. They accept what you are telling, which are non-contradictory to scriptural injections. Understand this way. Don't think that I want to win him, I want to defeat him, I want to show that I am better than him. Then Krishna will cut your proud. He also, he curbed the false ego of Arjuna, Hanuman, many, many. He doesn't want anyone should not get puffed up with their false ego. False ego means Krishna's enemy. Okay? Try to convince them. For that one, you have to do your sadhana nicely.
In a continuation to that, Prabhu, if somehow that other person felt hurt by preaching,
you are bold,
but he felt hurt. Okay, that means we have caused miseries. That's fourth principle.
No. You are perfect on your way. You are telling boldly. But even if you can tell him boldly in such a way that when he accepts that one, it is nice. But he feels that your words are hurting. So you have to change your way of presentation. And some people I told already, those who are adamant, arrogant, whatever may be the thing you say, they don't accept. For them, we have to pray to Krishna on them. There are so many people, it's not necessary that one. So many people that, I did my MBA, I did my MMC, I can give lecture. That's not possible. Only by the mercy of Guru and Krishna we can do preaching. This other material qualification is not going to help. You cannot help spiritually. Try to understand if that person is adamant. You just stop your argument and ask him, at least you can beg him to chant Hare Krishna. You understand? That is enough. You need not fully convince him. You can understand now, as he is arguing, whether he is flexible or not, he is adamant or what. You can understand him. So you need not go, you cannot stretch it. If you try to stretch it, what will happen? It will break. Elasticity also got some limitation. Don't go beyond that. Okay? Anything else? Okay? Hare Krishna, thank you very much.